when it's backed up by these sort of heroes. Now, XXS on the Omni Knight is always going to be by there, by SECC's side, just buffing up this quarter. Incredible potential at just 16 minutes in. And Gipke, he comes forward. Aster's there with a wraparound. Can they save their Meepo? Defensive disruption will come out. XXS on the front lines. 19T's going to step forward, but the Fiend's Grip is there from the high ground. But Boca locking down the Razor. Gipke's trying to run, but he cannot get out of it. Chuan's up to the high ground. They've lost three. It's a triple kill for SECC. And the fight, it's not over yet. SECC and Chuan are coming over to clean up the rest of them. Here comes the clears. Ultra kill. This man at 16 minutes. He's looking for the rampage. You'll get it off the hell there. Five heroes down on Forza. This game, I think it might be time to...
If Rumbling loses, what happens?
What do you mean, what happens?
How do you feel?
They'll patch the game and buff Morphling. I mean, this is meant to guarantee you a win. What's going on?
The smoke. No ulti still from ES.
The follow-up, Fisher? Keep him chainstunned, keep him chainstunned. A beautiful Winter's Curse in the back line to make sure there's no interception. And just like that, Arteezy's dead.
My God, you were right.
I've enjoyed watching this game of Dota 2, haven't we? It's been a great game. EG, they tried really, really hard. I do want to give it to them for that. They tried their best. They really did, and hats off to them for their 27-minute attempt. You pick Earthshaker Morph. If you start all chatting, that's a bit of a yikes. I'll be honest, yeah, that's...
He has BKB and Gem. Is he going to pop any items, any abilities on Ramses?
Trying. BKB's popped Ramses. He's hiding.
The Shadow Amulet.
Still just dismantling them.
Okay.
Piece by piece. Ramses does have the buy, but they got the Hex, the Omni Slash. Cold Embrace. Cataclysm's down, but XXS is in mid. They get the RP to three of them.
No jumps on the other side.
They got a follow-up damage.
He
steers
them
over the Fissure. Slams down. They're focusing the jump, but Arteezy's got the Blade Fury. SCCC will jump away. Looks towards Fly. Tag team there from XXS, and he comes in and helps get the kill.
It's
a triple kill for SCCC. Ultra kill for SCCC. The Fissure's out. Over he comes. Rampage. Double Rampage.
And GG called.
It's
welcome. To hell.
Welcome
to hell, my friend. Earthshaker Morphling.
Oh, now they're making a move in. Roar from Universe gets the snatch for Faith here. A jump in from SC, though. Big Deputy Blast is going to push him back, and Faith's going to be able to get off the False Promise on himself and stay good. Tornado fly forward, looking to go for crit. KP will follow up with a crush inside the pit. Sumail caught very low here. Unai going to be able to get the finish. Now Arteezy looking to square up with him. Moves him on in, the back end of the BKB, but KP intercepts, jumps in with a crush, slows him on down, blasting in the fly on out, and now with a blinding light, KP not going to be able to get off any sort of shots, but that ice wall man
OP
from SC,
wall,
right on top of Arteezy, and he can't move, slow and sluggish to be able to make it back in the way, he does pounce to the high ground, and he's going to be good, or will he? SC on the chase, catches up with the blink dagger, him and KP, a swing and a miss on the crush, but the faith nuking power coming out with a purifying flame.
Definitely worked out in their favor.
Now coming into high ground, EG, what are they going to do to stop it? Blast abundance here from Zai, but oh, a big move in, crush from KP, a follow-up combo comes out from SC as he shreds right through him. Quickly taking out Universe from the fight, no roar for you, sir, no buyback will be had. Newbie sweep through the competition now, but here comes the bounce back from EG. Sumail shrugging on in, and suddenly it's going to be U9 on the retreat. Now turnaround, there goes the Eclipse. Sumail does not want any piece of it. Arteezy going to be forced to pounce the low ground. SC dishes out the tornado. Will be able to catch on Zai. Turns it back. Lincoln's going to be popped now. Can they get the burst? Stuck in the ice wall there. Gets the right click. That's going to get Zai. Deafening blast. Move on in. Arteezy stuck in that same wall. Will be able to pounce and make it into the high ground, but he's still so slow. Looks like he'll be able to make it out from trouble here, but the onslaught continues as SC gets the next site. Going down and taking out crit. Now Sumail and Arteezy both look to tag team him, but he's going to be able to get off the tornado. He gets the false promise and says, back the hell off! I'm the true 9K here. Bow down before me. Arteezy cannot have a say in the matter as SC still continues to go to work. Unai will lose that Aegis, and now EG looking to make him pay. A pullback with the X with the pirate combo coming out. The boat is there, but SC moves on in, looks to go for Arteezy, and still will get the grab. Wicked sick, turns back tornado. The Universe still finally going to be able to get the roar off, but it's in a bad spot outside the base. Will it be enough? It will not. Sumail's here now, but ultimately will not be able to help him out with the deeps. Here's the buyback of Arteezy, as it looks like this could be the final save for EG. He is just desperate now, refuses to accept that SC Invoker is just doing so much work. SC not allowing it. Get the hell off me. Bumps him with a deafening blast. Blinks in front of him. Kaipi's going to be there with the crush.
Holy hell. I have never
seen. It is just nonstop. Don't even try it. They cannot do a thing about it.
I have never seen a single player.
Yep, they look for their opening. And they're going to find it. Dogfights, the first one, the Observer Ward. Actually, they break the smoke already. So IGV gets some space, but they push him out with a rock drop once again. Will it be enough? The Raw Templar Assassin, she's dropping quickly and will go down. No buyback is available. And with the Fallop Suns and Upheaval, can Newbie still come out on top of this one? You put Paparazzi in the front lines, looking to SC. No Flame Guard to really. She will protect him long enough to get a slide of fist off in July. The Spirit Jump forward. SC's going to get more. A triple kill for him and the Searing Chain. Snicked Assassin. There's no extra stun available for him. An ultra kill for the Ember Spirit. And will they give him the Rampage? Just kicking him around into it. There she is! A Rampage and even the taunt from KP in the middle of it. IG Vitality loses.
We got it. Split here second. We go. Look at this.
Did they catch a glimpse of him?
Oh!
Yeah, that was.
My goodness. That was so close. So, was it? Oh, he's literally the same
perfect
frame.
But they catch him,
Tom. Oh,
my God, no. And he had
status.
Oh, the A blast, though?
Oh!
Oh, he's fine.
This man, he's had some great Ember today in this game.
Fair enough. I haven't played Swarm with the Axe, but
way to
take down, grabs himself the Aegis.
But as they make their way back up to the high ground, Liquid could be there waiting for him. Oh, man.
Oh,
Unite tries to walk up, but they get a huge monster pull coming up from SCC. There goes the blast. Can they shrug off the damage? GH is already down along with the Dazzle. This could be Newbie's time. Lead in. There goes the Burrow. Is it going to be enough? Epi does not seem to get enough damage in there. Omni Slash now flying out for Miracle. Buybacks come out. GH back in the game now. U9 could be pulled back. SCC gets the double pull. And it's going to be the takedown of Miracle here as SCC looks to get the takedown of GH. It could be a dieback here, a very risky one for Liquid. While over on the other side, it's Matumba Man caught deep on the enemy's territory.
Yeah, as they do, they'll see the ward there, but Newbie are already on the way. Trying to catch him while they go for the D ward.
Oh, he gets
a beautiful
catch!
SCCC, my God! Gets a beautiful pullback onto him, is able to burst right through Mind Control and the Dazzle, but can they get the clutch finish here? Liquid able to hold their ground and fight it out with their own Abyssal play. Can they get the burst through? They're still holding on. Blinding Light to bump them back, and now they look to focus and surround Matumba Man. They will get the Aegis down. Sliding and scooting away, GH trying to make a retreat. Forced to leave, Matumba Man back and behind. Him and Miracle, the slow movers, trying to get out from this one. Matumba Man will get burst down. He has no buyback. Frantic to make it out. Omni Slash is there. SEC is going to be forced to go down and go right into a buyback. KP, no buyback for him. GH re-engaging will end up losing his life. But as Miracle makes his return, he should be also going down here, and he will get dropped. He does.
Oh, but now.
They know there's no Ravage. There's no big abilities on the side of Newbie. If they could sneak this, they could reset the game a little bit.
They've got the cooldown coming, the Static Storm as well. It's Traveler's over in Mind Control. Snowball comes in, GH trying to buy some time for Matumba, but GH is falling low. The Arcane Orb's bringing him down. They've got the Surface Squad. He needs to be able to keep alive with the Evasion. Mind Control and Matumba Man trying to turn things around. He has the Shape Shift trapped up again by the Kinetic Field. Defensive Astral onto Fave, but Matumba Man will chase it. Take down the Disruptor. Looking towards KP. The Sleep is there. Kaka, what do they want to do? They want to disengage by looks of Newbie, keeping to the high ground. Shard is going to come up on a I believe that does block the path up for SCCC if they want to retreat, but SCCC, he's trying to man up. He's looking towards Matumba, snowball from GH, closing the gap onto Moogie, force up to the high ground from SCCC, turning towards Kuro. They will keep chasing him. Moogie's trapped up by these ice shards in the river. He's going back into the rocket barrage and the flat cannon. He maybe be able to bring GH, he does, but he's going to surely pay with his life. Raze is there for Miracle. They've taken down two in return. SCCC trying to find Kuro, but the overgrowth out once more, and KP, Kaka and SCCC just have to retreat, and with that play, Liquid can move themselves back into the pit and attempt for the Roshan. Sanity's Eclipse is back up fairly shortly.
He's got 56 Ravage installed, and he wants this.
KP wants to go for the big play.
They're locking in.
He's going in. There's the Ravage.
He's going
to
drop it.
They start to rack up the intel. It's going to be a big Sanity's from SCCC. It's the ultra kill, SCCC. You know this man. He wants his revenge.
If they can get a good pickoff in mid, this gives a great opening for Troll to just rush into the Rosh pit. But looks like they want all five for the mid.
I think they have to have Troll for this kill on U9. They're going to lead. Whoa, 456 already showing himself. Lasso, pullback on U9. There's going to be no response from Tongfu right away. But oh, God. Relocate back, not going to be good enough. And now here comes the puck. It's going to be able to get a three-man dream call. Nice setup. Here comes the Avalanche. RP! Static Storm! Oh, God! It's a massacre! Togfu! They walked into a trap, and they're all going to die here as newbie youth.
You can always buy a rapier.
Now, they're going to try to do some sort of fight. Moogie, he gets multicast. They're going to try to run in. Now, Rezzo, his ulti a little bit off there, but here we go. KP is going to throw out a black hole. It only hits onto one, but it's the one you need. Oh, MSS gets him on out of their Cataclysm. Will go out. Doesn't do too much, but Rezzo, he is getting handled by his own team. Whoa. Meteor's going to come down, and look at this Deafening Blast. Hits on all four of them, and SCC just turns the fight. Here comes Jawar. He pops his ulti, but it's not going to do much. You get Moogie, but it's now a 30k lead. Four buybacks to come in. Can they pick anyone else off? It doesn't look like it.
High going for another Courier Snipe. We'll find it.
Ooh, that was the AC recipe. So that's the Assault Grass going for a bit. I mean, Pi, he'll give his life up for this one. DJ does come in with a four-man stun and silence. Tries to roll out as well. DJ will survive for now. They're going to try and take this fight here, Fnatic. Abed goes for the Stone Gaze. Will proc it onto a couple of them. The Static Storm's down onto the producer. Moogie actually still alive. He's not even going to need to use the Aegis.
And Abed's dead. Kaka whiffs the Echo.
They've got the buyback coming out from Abed. He knows that they've got to do the best. This fight is looking incredibly bad for Fnatic. Can they do anything to hold this one? Universe in trouble. Gets rooted. Moogie turning towards his next target.
Ghosts are available in 3 seconds. That's when Fnatic can make a real defense here. With the Rax.
They're falling, and there seems to be nothing that Fnatic can do to keep them off. Arbed. Yes, Decrep, live drain as well, beating into him. Envy's going to come forward. They go for the play as well. DJ with a three-man stun and silence, but
Envy
is being focused. Pops the Yule Scepter. KP's still alive for now. They've got the dust. Can they finish off KP? Jump forward for DJ. He's looking for the Underlord, and they'll find it, but DJ pays with his life. They've lost DJ. Arbed trying to get himself back up to the high ground. Gets
they glimpse him back.
Back down. They've got the control. Arbed will fall. That's the dieback. He's gone for 80 seconds. Envy will fall as well. SCCC cleaning up with the SUCCC. Triple kill as this Pugner just drains them all.
This Aghanim's just putting in so much work in the fights. Just constantly able to do so much damage.
More pressure. I think it's time to also leave that lane. I believe on bottom lane too, that tier 2 tower. The slide of Fitzhugh chains! Samael actually caught him! In the trees! SCC, he's BKB'd up, but where do you go from here? He's jumping through the tree line. They don't know. They don't know. They actually got him. He'll wait in the trees. The courier passes by with a maelstrom, but they don't know anything. His ship's in the night. EG is checking everywhere, but where he is, SCC will blink and walk away.
It just the timing was perfect. The boat came in from one side. He came in from the other. All right, let's see what you can do, newbie. But I think they just know. Yeah, this one's over, and they're going to make IG work for it.
Is this the crit? The crit of Destiny?
Buy a Blink Dagger. You actually have to buy a Blink Dagger.
That's what I'm saying. Get that positioning in.
Okay, they suddenly have the buyback now on Moogie. Just got the money for it.
They're just sheep sticking the Kunkka.
Fortification. They're buying it out as best they can. Moogie runs it. Pull back. Big blast.
One shot the DK.
DK is gone. Aggressive is barely holding on. Had to run out the other side.
Oh my god.
And newbie managed to hold with the sheer output of damage that they're able to dish. Frantic IG run out the other side. They don't have buybacks on those cores. But Boca makes it to the high ground here, but they chase him on out. Here comes the Kunkka, looking to swing the mighty Death Sword here. And boom!
It doesn't look that impressive when it's not on a creep, but yeah. When he crits a creep, he one-shot the DK, and he took all but like 100 health of the Lifestealer.
How much HP